How's it going, everyone? That's right. We are putting an episode out on a Monday. This is part of a series I've been waiting to do for a long time. So I'm just going to go ahead and move forward with it. This is going to be called the Monday Minutes. And I want to talk about some topics that I think are important that investors should be mindful of, but aren't dense enough to really go through and talk about for, let's say, 45 minutes or an hour and have an entire interview. So just little tidbits that I think, especially if you're building a large portfolio, something to be mindful of. So if you do like this episode today, make sure to let me know at info@cashflowconnections.com. And if you don't like this episode, make sure to let me know as well. I want to be as knowledgeable and transparent as possible. So today we're going to talk about kind of achieving the two goals that most investors want to achieve. When you really break it down, most investors want cash flow and they also want value add creation that'll boost the IRR profile. Now, unfortunately, especially late in the cycle, it's challenging to achieve both of those goals simultaneously within the same investment vehicle. So one of the things that I think investors should be contemplating is different investing strategies that have different risk profiles so you can achieve both of those goals in your entire portfolio rather than focusing all of your investments on just one type of investment vehicle or one asset class. So one of the ways that we do this, at least, is looking at the mobile home park and self-storage business. The mobile home park business is relatively straightforward. It's a simple business, especially when you consider the fact that developing new mobile home parks is basically illegal. That completely eliminates that in terms of juicing the return profile. So the mobile home park business, you basically raise rents, decrease expenses, and you may have the ability to bring in some additional homes. Generally speaking, it's a cash flow focused business. Now that cash flow is relatively predictable. The outcome is very predictable. Therefore, the risk is relatively lower. But you're not going to get that same IRR profile, all things being equal, as if you're going through some massive capital expenditure, converting a C-class property to an A-class property, just to use an extreme. So to sort of balance that out and achieve both of those, the self-storage business, on the other hand, much more complicated. You can do things like buy C-class self-storage, turn it into A-class self-storage. You can buy standard units, turn them into climate-controlled units. And when you're going through a transition like that, you're incurring risk because you're putting up capital. You're going through a capital expenditure to accomplish that value-add creation. Now, when you put up additional capital, that means that the return profile from a cash flow standpoint is going to be lower, especially in the beginning years. So when the cash flow is lower, the predictability of the outcome is also lower. You're hoping that taking on that additional risk will result in a higher IRR profile. So when you're looking at building a portfolio, especially a seven-figure portfolio, I think it's a good idea to have a good combination of both stabilized and value-add focused investments, because that's the only way you're going to accomplish both of those goals. If you're only focused on cash flow, you're going to be very limited. And here's a really important part. If you're limited in your investments to one risk profile, not only are you not diversified, but you may not be able to invest in a lot of vehicles that will offset the other investments you made. So for example, if you have a really high cash flow investment, you can offset that investment with a more value-add focused investment. And therefore, cumulatively, you have both of those. You have the in-place cash flow, and you also have the boost in the returns. And this allows you to be more active in the investment space. It allows you to open up more doors in terms of the types of vehicles that'll be appropriate for your investment profile. So that's just a quick thing to think about as you're building a portfolio. I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know, and we'll keep these going. Thanks again. All right, listeners, you know the routine. This show is all about learning, making wise investments, and protecting and growing your capital. So if you're interested in these topics, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Of course, if you've already enjoyed a couple of great episodes, don't be shy. Leave a review. It really helps the show's visibility. And lastly, if you're an accredited investor and you're interested in learning more about our investment opportunities, the types of deals that I personally invest in, go to asymcapital.com. That's asymcapital.com. Thanks a lot.